On Godot 4.4, adding buttons to the inspector has never been easier. You can have your node scripts execute anything you want with the click of a button. To do that is really simple. Create a new script and add the add_to at the top so it can run code in the editor. Create the function you want to execute, and then use the decorator @export_to button. Pass in the name of the button and the optional icon to use. And below that, create a variable that will hold the callable that will execute when the button is pressed, and set it to the function you want to be called when pressed. You can now see the button, but it won't work just yet. You need to save and restart the scene once for the button to be created correctly. So go to scene, reload saved scene. And now the button works. Now you can use this button to do some stuff. But there is still one important issue left. Here's the code to reposition children nodes along a line. You can click the button and it will move all the nodes. But you can't undo the action, and this can be very dangerous. So, Godot makes it very easy for us to fix that. You need to tell Godot what action the button took and how to undo it. So use the editor interface to get the editor's UndoRedo manager. Then we use UndoRedo.createAction to start an action. And instead of setting the position directly, save them to a variable called newPos, and use the UndoRedo.addo property to set the position instead. Set the object we are changing, the property to change, and the value you want to change it to. And then we also need to call the addUndo property to tell what it will do when the undo action happens. So here, we pass the current node's position, so it returns to where it was. And finally, after everything is done, we call undoRedo.commitAction. This will execute all the do properties and finally move our nodes. Now we can use the inspector button without fear. And even undo its action, making it very easy to create useful tools really fast. Or maybe just simple scripts to help you debug faster. But that's it. Now you can use two buttons to automate anything, or use them in any way you want to help you with your games. I hope this video helps, and until next time.